Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Sheena. Well, today we are trying another makeup look that's gonna be different from the ones I've tried in the past, yet very simple to achieve in case you are a beginner. Today's video will not be focusing on the products that I'm using, but on little techniques, some new products, some new things that I'm using in this particular look, and also a step-by-step guide to how to do this look if you are a beginner. So do watch this video till end, and yeah, stay tuned and keep watching.
Right, first things first, I'm gonna first take these hair away from my face, and I'll quickly start with my face prep. Starting with my skin prep, I'll be first moisturizing my face properly. Also my lips, I'll be moisturizing it as step number one, which is a very crucial one. Second, I'll be applying primer. I am only applying to my T-zone, and then I'll smoothly spread it to the entire face, which will give me an even tone, a nice canvas to do a makeup on my face. Moving ahead to step number three, which is applying foundation. I'll be applying foundation in smaller amounts on the entire face, and this time I'm using a new technique to blend my foundation, which is with the help of a blending brush and not a beauty blender. Now, difference between using a brush and a beauty blender is that brush will give you more coverage of your product on the face, whereas the beauty blender absorbs a lot of product and gives you much more natural look. So this time I kind of thought of using a brush, hence I'm blending the entire product with the help of a brush in a very smooth manner in a light hand, and I'll make sure that I spread my product to the entire face, into the hairline. I will not forget to, you know, use the product on my neck as well, so that it gives an even tone and an even color to both face and neck, and doesn't give a dual color tone to my face and neck individually. So I'll make sure that I blend my product very nicely, and will take those extra few seconds to blend my product really nice. Now, if you see that with the help of a brush, it gives much more coverage. Even if your product is, you know, light to medium coverage product, it will give you a high coverage with the help of a brush. Moving ahead to next step, which is applying concealer. I'm first using the concealer which matches my skin tone, and I'm applying it with the help of the, you know, wand that comes with this product. And then again, I am also blending the concealer with the help of a blending brush only, and I'm not using beauty blender at all. So I'll take this concealer brush, and with the help of this brush, I'm, you know, blending entire concealer. I've applied it under my eyes to cover my dark circles, and then on the high points of my face to conceal any kind of imperfections, any discoloration that you might have on the face. And I'll make sure that I use a very light hand, and I, you know, blend the product very softly. Now, while I'm using this brush, I feel that the product blends much more, you know, properly and in a nicer manner if you use a beauty blender. I don't know, I feel it that way, but I wanted to use the brush especially for concealer. So what I'll do is that once I am done blending it with the help of a brush, I will definitely use a beauty blender once in the end to kind of blend it all properly. Now, in this step, I'm using another concealer which is a shade or two lighter to my skin tone. You can always skip this step if you do not feel the need, but I feel that, you know, utilizing this particular tone of concealer is basically used to highlight the face, the high points of your face, in case you wish to. It's totally a person to person. In case anybody wants to skip this particular step and use the minimal products, is as per choice, but I am taking this step, one extra step of using a lighter concealer on my face. It's just to brighten the face, you know, with the help of a makeup, that's all. One can always skip this step. Again, with the help of a brush only, I am blending this concealer as well, which I've put on the high points of my face to give that little highlighting effect with this particular product. So once I am done blending, now, as I said, I'll be using a damp beauty blender, and just with a very soft hands, I will blend all these products that I've applied on my face once all together, so that I feel that the product has really been absorbed and kind of blended well on my face and doesn't really show awkwardly. And it shows that it's blended properly. Hence, I'm taking this additional step of using a beauty blender even after using the blending brushes. Alright, once we are done with this step, I'm gonna move ahead to my next step, which is packing the concealer and locking the concealer with compact powder. One can even use loose powders, banana powders, setting powders that come in different brands and different ranges. I have this, powder, compact powder, so I'll be using the same, and again a very little amount with the help of this brush, and I'll apply only to those areas where I've applied concealer so that it remains at its place and doesn't creases if you're wearing this makeup all day long. That's the intent. Moving ahead to contouring, again with the help of a brush, I am contouring my face. First, on the cheekbones, I'll take it in a vertical motion, and then to blend it, I'll rotate my brush, in a circular motion so that it gives a blended look and does not give any kind of harsh lines on my face. On both the sides, I'll be blending it really nicely with the help of the brush. Once done, I will also be contouring not just my cheekbones, but also my forehead, also the lower chin area, also the nose. So I take those extra few seconds and little extra time to blend the product, because I really want to feel that satisfaction that yes, I've blended the product really well. So, doing the chin and doing the forehead is quite easy because you do not really need any particular technique. But on the cheekbones, it's little, you need that extra care. Now, this is another technique that I'm using to contour my nose. You do not need sleeker brushes. You can always use that fluffy brush. Press it between your fingers and make it like a pressed brush, and then you can contour your nose with the help of a fluffy brush as well. So you do not really need those 1,000 brushes to do each makeup step. You can always use one or two brushes to kind of do the entire makeup. Hence, I'm using this hack, which I also learned myself from various YouTube videos, and I'm using it. Moving on to blush, again, I am using a blush in a more in a fashion that it looks like a flushed cheek. It gives you that, sun-kissed look, and I do not really like a pigment on one spot. Hence, I'm blending it really nice on the entire cheek and taking it upward so that my face looks really tight and it gives a nice blended and flushed look, a very natural look. Since we are doing a red lips look this time, so I want to keep my face very, very subtle and do not want that my eyes and cheeks come out too much. I'm using the same blush to use on the lower side of my eyebrows as well, on the eyebrow bone basically, to give that nice tanned look, because with red lips the kind a little tanned and sun-kissed look looks really nice. Moving to eyebrows, I am filling my eyebrows with a dark brown pencil. Now, this is basically an eye pencil from MAC, but this color really suits, so I also use it, do a multi-purpose thing with this, and I also use to fill my eyebrows. Please make sure that you fill your eyebrows with a very, very light hand, because if you really put in harsh lines, it'll give you a very artificial look. Moving ahead to eyes, now again, I am taking color, which is more of a matte finished color, and I'll be applying it on the crease area. I'll first deposit the product on the outer corner of my eye. Once done, whatever left, I'll put it over the crease, and I'm also taking it out in a winged manner that looks like a wing. I'm doing the same on the other side of the eye as well. So with a very light hand, first I deposit it on the outer corner of the eye, and whatever is left on the brush, I take it on the entire crease. That's what I'm doing with this particular color. Now I'll take another color, which is more of a shinier color in a metallic finish, and just with the help of my finger, I'm applying it on the lids of my eyes. With a very, very light hand, again, I'm applying it because it'll give a little shine on the eyes. So this is a little champagne color, again, from the MAC palette. And just with the help of fingers, I'm applying it only on the lids area, because we've already covered our, crease area with a matte shade. Any color, any shade that you would want to use, please use that as per your choice. Hence, I'm not really focusing on colors and products this time, more on techniques and step-by-step guide to how did I create this look. Alright, moving ahead to next step, which is eyeliner. Now, this is an overwhelming step for me because I take a lot of time to apply eyeliner even after I do a lot of practice. But that's okay. The more you apply, the more your hands become sturdy and you'll be able to apply it in a very smooth matte. This eyeliner is from the brand Sugar Cosmetics, and they have got wide ranges of eyeliners and now in different new vibrant colors as well. But this one I have bought, it is in the form of sketch pen, which makes it much easier for a beginner to apply, and it gives a very nice matte finish in case you are a matte finish person, so you'll really like it. Yes, I'm applying it and then I'll repeat the same on the other eye. Moving ahead to mascara. Now this one is from the brand MAC Cosmetics. Trust me, if you're looking for, you know, kind of buying a new mascara for yourself, go for MAC Cosmetics, because the wand that comes with this particular product is really nice. It just does not only coats your eyelashes but separates them, so it gives a very uplifted look. Alright, moving to our first hero of this particular look, which is eyelashes from the brand Huda Beauty. I've applied it off camera. I'll definitely record another video in terms of how I, apply eyelashes. Yes, this is the second hero of the makeup look, which is red lipstick. Now this one is from the brand Nykaa. It's a liquid lipstick but ends with a superb matte finish. It's in the shade Maharani. Do try it because it's one of the beautiful reds that really suits my face. But trust me, it's a really nice lipstick. Finishing my look with highlighter on some high points of my face. I have actually mixed silver and gold tone, and just with the help of my fingers, I'm applying highlighter. Setting the entire makeup with makeup fixer. I've sprayed a little on Beauty Blender and I'm applying it in a dab motion. And yeah guys, this is my final look. Do let me know how did you like the look, and do not forget to subscribe and share in case you have not done so far. So yeah, I'll see you in my next one. Till then, bye, take care guys.